Welcome to Amazing Weapons. Imagine you are a commander in a war zone. You have a target that is hidden, moving, or hard to reach. You need a weapon that can find and destroy it with minimal risk and maximum efficiency. What do? You call for the IAI Harop, the ultimate loitering munition. What is a loitering munition, you ask? Well, it's a weapon that can fly like a drone, but also strike like a missile. It can loiter above the battlefield for hours, searching for targets with its sensors. It can be controlled by a remote operator or act autonomously based on predefined rules. And when it finds a target, it can dive into it and explode, causing maximum damage. Sounds awesome, right? Well, that's what the IAI Harop is. It's a loitering munition developed by Israel Aerospace Industries, one of the world's leading defense companies. The IAI Harop is a larger version of the IAI Harpy, which was the first loitering munition ever created. The IAI Harop has a range of 1,000 kilometers, a loiter time of 6 hours, and a warhead of 23 kilograms. It can be launched from land, sea, or air platforms, and it can attack both static and moving targets on land or at sea. The IAI Harop was developed in the early 2000s and has been sold to several countries, including India, Turkey, Azerbaijan, and Germany. It has been used in combat in several conflicts, such as the Nagorno-Karabakh War between Azerbaijan and Armenia. In fact, the IAI Harop was so effective that it was nicknamed the kamikaze drone by some media outlets. In this video, we will tell you more about the IAI Harop, its features, its capabilities, and its performance. We will also show you some clips of the IAI Harop in action, destroying targets with precision and accuracy. So stay tuned and enjoy the show. The IAI Harop is not your ordinary drone. It's a weapon that can fly like a drone, but also strike like a missile. Let's take a closer look at its design and specifications. The IAI Harop is a large and sleek aircraft, with a wingspan of 3 meters and a length of 2.5 meters. It weighs 135 kilograms, including a 23 kilograms warhead that can penetrate armored vehicles, bunkers, or ships. It has a turbojet engine that can propel it at speeds of up to 260 kilometers per hour. It has a range of 1,000 kilometers, which means it can fly to and from the target area without refueling. And it has a loiter time of 6 hours, which means it can stay in the air for a long time, looking for targets. The IAI Harop has a sophisticated sensor system that includes an electro-optical camera, an infrared camera, and a radar. These sensors allow it to see in day and night, in all weather conditions, and in different spectrums. The sensors also enable it to identify and track targets, such as radars, vehicles, buildings, or ships. The IAI Harop is not just a smart weapon. It's also a versatile weapon. It can be launched from different platforms, such as trucks, ships, or planes. It can be controlled by different modes, such as man-in-the-loop or autonomous. And it can attack different types of targets, such as static or moving, land or sea. How does the IAI Harop work? Well, it depends on the mission and the mode. But here is a general overview of how it operates. First, the IAI Harop is launched from a ground or sea-based canister, or from an air platform. The launch can be done remotely or manually, depending on the situation. Second, the IAI Harop flies to the target area, using its GPS navigation system and its inertial navigation system. The flight can be pre-programmed or adjusted in real time, depending on the intelligence and the terrain. Third, the IAI Harop loiters above the target area, using its sensors to search for and detect targets. The loitering can be done at high or low altitude, depending on the stealth and the visibility. Fourth, the IAI Harop attacks the target, using its warhead to crash into it and explode. The attack can be done by a remote operator who selects the target and triggers the strike, or by an autonomous mode that follows predefined rules of engagement. The attack can also be aborted or self-destructed at any time, if the situation changes or if the target is not valid. That's how the IAI Harop works. It's a weapon that combines the best of both worlds, the flexibility of a drone and the lethality of a missile. It's a weapon that can find and destroy any target with minimal risk and maximum efficiency. You might think that the IAI Harop is the ultimate loitering munition, but wait, there's more. IAI has also developed some variants and adaptations of the Harop for different scenarios and needs. Let's take a look at some of them. First, we have the Mini Harop or Green Dragon. This is a smaller version of the Harop designed for smaller applications. It's 1/5 the size of the Harop and has a lighter 3 to 4 kilograms warhead. It has a shorter endurance of 2 to 3 hours. and is used tactically against time-critical targets or ones that hide and reappear, the Mini Harop can be launched from a ground vehicle or a helicopter and can carry up to 12 or 16 units respectively. The Mini Harop is ideal for urban warfare where precision and low collateral damage are required. Second, we have the Rotom L or Rotom H. These are rotary wing versions of the Harop designed for vertical takeoff and landing. They have a similar size and weight as the Harop, but have a longer endurance of 10 hours. They can be launched from anywhere, without the need for a launcher or a runway. They can also hover over a target area, providing real-time intelligence and surveillance. The Rotom L is optimized for low-altitude operations, while the Rotom H is optimized for high-altitude operations. Third, we have the Maritime Harop. This is a naval version of the Harop designed for maritime missions. It has a similar range and loiter time as the Harop, but has a different warhead that can penetrate naval vessels. It can be launched from ships or submarines and can attack both surface and underwater targets. The Maritime Harop can also operate in anti-access area denial environments where conventional weapons are ineffective. IAI has created a whole family of loitering munitions based on the Harop concept. Each variant has its own advantages and disadvantages, depending on the situation and the objective. But they all share one thing in common: they can change the course of any battle. The IAI Harop is not only a remarkable weapon, but also a proven weapon. It has been used in combat by several countries, in different situations and environments. Let's see how the IAI Harop performed in some of its most notable missions. First, we have the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict between Azerbaijan and Armenia. This is a long-standing dispute over a disputed territory in the South Caucasus region. The conflict escalated in 2016 and 2020, with both sides using various weapons and tactics. But one weapon that stood out was the IAI Harop, used by Azerbaijan. The Harop was used to strike Armenian targets such as buses, tanks, radars, command posts, and air defenses. The Harop was so effective that it earned the nickname of the kamikaze drone by some media outlets. The Harop was also credited for helping Azerbaijan gain a decisive advantage over Armenia and forcing them to sign a peace deal in November 2020. Second, we have the Israeli Defense Forces operation against Syria in 2018. This was a response to an Iranian drone that infiltrated Israeli airspace from Syria. The IDF launched a series of airstrikes against Iranian and Syrian targets in Syria, using various weapons and platforms. One of them was the IAI Harop, which was used to destroy a Syrian air defense system known as the SA-22 Greyhound. The Harop was able to evade the radar and missiles of the SA-22 and hit it with precision and accuracy. The Harop was also praised for its stealth and reliability, as it was able to operate in a complex and hostile environment. Third, we have the evaluation of the IAI Harop by other countries, such as India, Turkey, Germany, and the United Kingdom. These are some of the customers and potential customers of the Harop who have shown interest and appreciation for its capabilities and features. India has been one of the largest buyers of the Harop, having ordered more than 160 units since 2009. India has renamed the Harop as P-4 and has used it for various purposes, such as training and testing. Turkey has also been a launch customer of the Harop since 2005 and has used it for various missions, such as counter-terrorism and border security. Germany has also acquired some units of the Harop in 2009 and has deployed them in Afghanistan for reconnaissance and surveillance. The United Kingdom has also considered the Harop as one of the finalists for its loitering munition program in 2005, but ultimately chose a British alternative. The IAI Harop has a rich combat history and performance record. It has been used by different countries in different scenarios and conditions. It has demonstrated its effectiveness and impact in various situations and targets. It has also received positive feedback and recognition from various sources and experts. It is clear that the IAI Harop is not just an amazing weapon, but also a successful weapon. We have reached the end of our video about the IAI Harop, the ultimate loitering munition. It has been used by several countries in different situations and environments. It has demonstrated its effectiveness and impact in various situations and targets. It has also received positive feedback and recognition from various sources and experts. The IAI Harop is a weapon that represents the future of warfare. It is a weapon that combines the best of both worlds, the flexibility of a drone and the lethality of a missile. It is a weapon that can find and destroy any target with minimal risk and maximum efficiency. But the IAI Harop is also a weapon that raises some ethical and legal questions. Is it right to use a weapon that can kill without human intervention? Is it fair to use a weapon that can evade detection and defense? Is it safe to use a weapon that can malfunction or be hacked? These are some of the questions that we need to think about as we enter a new era of warfare. What do you think about the IAI Harop? Do you think it is a game changer or a nightmare? Do you think it is a good or a bad thing? Do you think it should be regulated or banned? Let us know in the comments below. And what do you expect from the next generation of loitering munitions? Do you think they will be more advanced or more dangerous? Do you think they will be more common or more rare? Do you think they will be more diverse or more uniform? Let us know in the comments below. Thank you for watching our video about the IAI Harop, the ultimate loitering munition. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more amazing weapons videos. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to get notified when we upload new videos. See you next time.